Hello, I am Dr. Tushar Kaushik from the Department of Biodiversity and Paleobiology Group of the Agarka Research Institute. I work on Foraminifera. The Foraminifera is a group of highly diverse, single-celled eukaryotic protists, and they are exclusively marine. In short, we call them forams. They are ubiquitous in ocean and inhabit almost all marine rheams, from the transitional zones of coastal regions to the deep sea environments. Our group sampled them from diverse marine environments, from the muddy intertidal waters of the west coast of India to the largest mangrove ecoregion, that is the Sundarbans, and from the open ocean of the Indian sector of Southern Ocean or Antarctic waters. So we sample these foraminifers using various experimental techniques.
To catch the organisms at particular depth, we use an instrument called multi-plankton net, which is pulled up vertically through the water column. It can carry up to 5 different nets with a defined porosity. Each net can be programmed to open at particular depth within water column to catch organisms. We collect this organism and process it on board. The oceanic bed is filled with the shells of dead forams. These shells are considered as microfossils. To collect the sediment sample, we use both box corer and gravity corer. We collect sediment samples in sterile sample bag and preserve it on board.
These foraminifera are about sand grain size and are microscopic in nature, that is, we require help of high-end microscopes to study them. As you have seen, these microscopic organisms, that is, our foraminifera, comes in various shapes and sizes and sometimes look like aliens. These are the pictures of few of the forams from the coastal and open oceans. As you have observed in previous images, that many of these forams covers themselves with a hard shell or a test. Their shell can be made up of calcium carbonate or agglutinate, that is, by attaching microscopic grains of sediments from the ambient environment. Such hard shells gets preserved in the sediments and accumulate through time, and hence may provide us a high resolution record of the past geological environment, or like many of us foraminiferologists call these forams a microscopic timekeepers. So many species of foraminifera are highly sensitive and they quickly respond to the changes in the environmental conditions. Assemblages of these species, or species-specific populations, or we can say that their communities, are generally associated with the regional habitats of the coastal regions. And this relationship is often applied to similar assemblages found in the time slices embedded in the paleosedimentary records, which is also known as foraminiferal transfer function. In addition to that, the calcite shell of foraminifera also provide us with an information about the physical and chemical signature of the ambient seawater in which they grow. This information is employed as the geochemical paleoproxy to reconstruct the paleo environment in which a particular foraminifera lived. However, the correct taxonomic identification is the basic prerequisite for using any species of foraminifera for the paleoceanographic, paleoclimatic, biostratigraphy and geochemical data reconstructions. Modern benthic foraminiferal morphospecies sometimes represent a complex of several distinct genetic types, or we also call them as genotypes, which may inhabit different ecological niche within a morphospecies range. These genotypes may represent a completely different species. Therefore, the significance of these morphological characters is questionable for the determination of closely related species or polymorphic taxa. Due to lack of morphological features for the discriminations of many such genotypes, researchers unknowingly pool a mixture of different genetic species because they look morphologically similar, also known as cryptic species. This may introduce a significant noise and error in the data of both transfer function methods and geochemical proxies. So, in order to provide solutions to these taxonomic problems, DNA-based molecular techniques offer us the information which is independent of morphological characters and provide criteria for revising controversial taxonomic problems that cannot be solved with morphological data alone. At Agartha Research Institute, our group employs traditional morphotaxonomical systematics and integrate it with the ribosomal DNA-based taxonomy approaches to solve many such problems on the identity of a species in foraminifera. It is most surprising that out of the major studied eukaryotes, the foraminifera were the only remaining protists with no ribosomal data sequences available from the Indian subcontinent yet. At Agartha Research Institute, our group is the first in the country to generate the first ribosomal DNA sequences for foraminiferal species and published it in a highly reputed journal in our field. Since then, we are embarked on an exercise to recognize as many species of foraminifera by using combined morphological, ecological and molecular approaches, and to provide solutions to many such taxonomy related issues. This will not only help us explore more species and assign each a valid lenient species name, but to improve the paleo records, because erroneous species identification have a serious potential to undermine the credibility of research, leading to flawed current and future research agendas. Therefore, it is imperative that a more robust and stable morphology-based taxonomy rooted in molecular systematics is developed and adopted widely. Moreover, discovery of a new species or a genus of foraminifera brings with it new opportunities that will help us improve regional as well as global biostratigraphy and play an important role in paleo-environmental reconstruction.